Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video, we will learn how to enable Spring Security using Facebook Authorization Server in our Spring Boot application. In our previous video, we have already discussed what is OAuth, and OAuth mainly stands for Open Authorization. So how it will works? We will create one Spring Boot application. And then user will send the request to our client application, and this request will be authorized with Facebook authorization server. And after verify the request, user will get response back from our Spring Boot application. So okay, let's start. First we will create one Spring Boot application. But before creating Spring Boot application, we need to create one app in Facebook. So here I will go to developer.facebook.com, and here we need to create one app so our Spring Boot application can communicate with Facebook. So here I will click on my apps, and here we just need to create one new app. So here we have three options. First one is manage business integration. Integration a third party gaming app. So here we will select for everything else because we need to integrating Facebook login. So here I will click on this, and here we just need to give the app display name. So here I will give name Gain Java Knowledge and click on create app ID. And here click on recapture and submit. So here we can see our application Gain Java Knowledge has created. Here now we just need to go on Facebook login, click on setup, and here we need to select the quick start to add Facebook login into our app. So here I will click on others and go back to our settings dashboard. So here we can see our app Gain Java Knowledge, and this is our app ID. So now I will go down, and here we will see my products. Under my products we can see Facebook login. So just click on settings, and here we can see client auth login is yes, and web auth login is also enabled. So here we no need to enter anything, just click on save changes. So here it saved successfully. Now just click on settings and go to basic, and here we can see it is our app ID, and this is app secret that we need to use when we want to communicate with our Facebook application. So now we will create one Spring Boot application. So here I will go to start.spring.io, and here we need to select project type is Maven, language Java, and Spring Boot version is 2.3.4. So here artifact will be Spring Security using OAuth Facebook. OAuth Facebook. So here we need to add the dependency. So here I will click on add dependency and select Spring Web, and second one we need to add OAuth 2, that is cloud OAuth 2, and the next, and the third one is we need to add Spring Security. So we have added three dependencies: Spring Web, cloud OAuth 2, and Spring Security. Now click on generate. Now here we will import this project into Eclipse. So go to Eclipse, click on import projects, existing Maven project, browse and finish. And here we can see our project has imported successfully. And here we need to create one Spring Boot REST endpoint. So here I will create one new package, and inside this package I will create one class. So here package will be facebook.controller and we'll create one message controller class. And in message controller class, we will create one REST endpoint, and this REST endpoint will be authorized with the help of Facebook authorization server. If Facebook's authorization server will validate the credentials, then we can only access this REST endpoint. So here I will just denote the annotation, that is at the rate REST controller. And here I will create one REST endpoint, public string get message, and we will pass principal as a parameter. And here I will just use at the rate get mapping. And this will be a Java security. With the help of this REST endpoint, I will just return one string message. So here I will just add press warnings. So here from this principal object, I will get the authentication details, and from this user authentication detail, I will get the name of the users, and then I will just return the username with the welcome message. So our endpoint will return this message. Now I will go to my main class, and here we need to enable auth also. So here I will just annotate annotation at the rate enable auth to SSO, that is single sign on. And here what we need to create, now we need to create one application.yml file. So here I will pass these credentials of our Facebook app, then our Spring Boot application can communicate with Facebook only. So here I will just click on resources package, and here I will create one new class, new file, that is application.yml, and finish. And here I will just paste all the properties that we required to communicate with our Facebook authorization server. So here we need to provide client ID and client secret so our application can communicate only with Facebook. So I will copy this client ID from here, that is our app ID, and just paste client ID here. And we also need client secret. So click on show, it will ask for password. And copy this from here and go to our application and paste it here. And here we just need to provide Spring application name. So I will go to my pom.xml and copy the name of our Spring Boot application, and now go to our application.yml file and paste it here. Now save it. Now I will just run our Spring Boot application, and we'll check our REST endpoint will authorize by Facebook or not. So here we can see my Spring Boot application has started on port number 8080. So now I will go to, on this screen I have already logged in Facebook, so I will go to Cognito window, and here I will just hit my REST endpoint localhost 8080. So here it will ask for Facebook credential, and then it will validate this credential. After validating this credential, only we can get the response from our REST endpoint. So just click on login. So here it will ask for your permission. Gain Java knowledge will receive your name and profile picture. So just click continue is gain. Then it will authorize. So here we can see the message returned by our REST endpoint, and this message returned after authorizer by Facebook. So here if I will hit this REST endpoint again, then it will not ask for our credentials because this is single sign-on application. So this all was about our Facebook authorization server and our Spring Boot application. So here we saw how we can enable Facebook authorization for our Spring Boot application. Okay, thanks for watching this video.